guys, it's
Tom
and Katie, and today we're sitting here in front of our Christmas tree that we just set up, and we are gonna go over what we brought to the hospital. I want to share what I realistically brought and used or needed in the hospital because I watched quite a few of these and there's so many options. So I'm just sharing personally what I packed for my unmedicated birth in a public hospital.
As well as that, our hospital stay ended up being a bit longer than anticipated. Originally, we thought we'd be in the hospital for like 24 to 48 hours, but little Sophie ended up having a little bit of jaundice. So we ended up being a few more days in the hospital, which was unexpected. So that really taught us a lesson of, oh my goodness, I wish we packed more of this, or oh my goodness, I'm so glad we have that. So a little insights in that sense too, if your hospital stay ends up being longer. So
make sure you're prepared. All right. Let's get into this. So I'm just gonna right off the bat get into the awkward stuff. So I brought adult diapers with me because everyone talked about how the hospitals supply mesh bottoms and pad inserts, and it just seemed a bit complicated, and I just knew I was going to be sore, and I knew I didn't want to have to deal with constantly changing and worrying about leaking. So I would definitely suggest don't even use the mesh bottoms and the pads, just go for adult diapers. It's all in one and it's a lot more convenient and a lot easier. The second thing I want to talk about is make sure you bring a few pairs of comfy clothes, so it can be sweat outfits or pajamas. So I brought these PJs with me. It was just a matching set, but specifically I was looking for a robe that would cover the back of me because I was wearing a diaper, and I also wanted a robe that could open up and close so that when I was breastfeeding I could just easily cover myself up. This was a super convenient set for me and I used it for a couple days because it was just so comfortable and it was practical. I also brought a pair of slippers with me because I knew I wanted to be comfy and I didn't want to be walking around just in socks, or especially not barefoot. So I just brought a pair of comfy slippers and it was really nice. They had good grip, so if I knew I was walking around with the baby, I wouldn't slip or anything. It's just things you need to think about because you don't want to be walking around in fluffy socks and like slipping around all over the place. So having a pair of these was really useful for the both of us.
Yeah, I will say that, like, especially as you can imagine when you're going through labor, there's a lot of pacing and walking around. So for Caitlin, it was so important for her to have something comfortable on her feet. So that was, you know, another thing is that you'd be surprised how much time you spend on your feet going through labor.
Oh, for sure. So I guess I kind of want to get into my labor stuff that I brought. Something that I actually forgot in my hospital bag, but I was like begging for it when we were there, is I really needed a hand fan. I was getting the worst hot flashes. I was giving birth in the middle of the summer and I felt so hot. So I really wish I had this, but I didn't pack it yet because I was using it so much during the summer months and I just knew I needed it. So I'm throwing this in there. Don't forget your hand fan. I talked about this in my unmedicated labor video, but lavender oil helped me so much during labor pain. I would literally pace with it under my nose, but I also would put it on my pillow when I was relaxing, and it helped me focus on something other than my pain, but it also was very relaxing for me. So anyway, make sure you pack this. So this is super silly, but someone gave me the advice of sucking on a lollipop during labor, and it actually was super helpful. This is like a Halloween lollipop, so mine didn't really look like this. I went through like 10 of these during labor, and it was really helpful for me to just, it was like a baby with a soother. It was very soothing, and I was focusing on the taste, and you can't eat while you're in labor, so it was really nice to just have something.
A bit of sugar.
Yeah, a bit of sugar and flavorful during my labor. Okay, this is something that I didn't use during my labor, but I know I could have, and I just chose not to because I was busy watching TV programs with you.
Yeah,
and I just
sort of stuff to distract.
Yeah, I had other distractions, but looking back, when I was lying down and we weren't really talking, I was just focusing on my breathing. I wish I would have had my music on. So I brought these to the hospital. I didn't end up using them, but for my next birth, I know I'm gonna be listening to music and preparing a playlist. And obviously make sure you have some kind of phone charger because you're going to want to take loads of videos, photos. You're going to want to contact your family, explain to them everything that happened.
I can honestly say after spending a few days in the hospital, I think one of the worst things that could have happened is if we didn't have phone chargers with us.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Definitely pack your phone charger.
Yeah, especially we were in the hospital for a few days and we couldn't have visitors. So it was really nice to communicate and FaceTime and have our phones charged up. So make sure you bring that. Make sure you bring enough things for your showers. I took several showers during my labor because I needed the heat for my pain. So I use flip-flops or slides a lot because I did not want to get my feet on those floors because I'm a germaphobe. You never know what's in those hospitals. So make sure you pack some flip-flops or slides or something like that. So when you're showering, you don't have to worry about that. One less thing you have to worry about during labor. Make sure you bring your toiletries, your toothbrush, toothpaste, face wash, moisturizer, shower gel, anything you use at home, make sure you bring, because they don't, at least for us, they didn't supply that. So I was so glad I had enough for like 3 days hospital stay so that I could take as many showers as I wanted.
And then there was like a little thing of toothpaste they gave us, but like it's just a bare minimum. So if you're used to a routine or certain things you like to use on your skin or your hair, like just so that you're comfortable and you feel as at home as possible, because it is such a hard thing to go through. So you want to be as comfortable and as relaxed as possible. So just having all your little stuff, don't totally rely on just the bare minimums the hospital provide.
I also brought my makeup bag. I only used it the day we were leaving the hospital because I was not coming into the hospital with makeup on, and I surely was not going to be doing my makeup every day. Like, you just don't have the energy. But we were meeting up with our families right when we left, so I was like, oh, fine, I'll have enough energy to do this. So it was nice to, as an option, have makeup, but also when we left for pictures and stuff. So make sure you bring your makeup back. And then since we were there for a few days, it was nice to have some dry shampoo just to freshen up the hair, maybe throw it up in a top knot. Made sure I had plenty of hair ties because I didn't know if I'd lose them or how I'd want my hair. So anyway, I used a hair tie during labor, during birth, and every day. I did not style my hair once. So make sure you have some hair ties. A couple of things you're gonna need when it comes to your breasts. You're gonna need some breast pads. I was leaking like crazy in the hospital. All my milk just came in. So I went through loads of these. So pack enough breast pads for sure, because you're just starting to develop milk. You don't know when your milk is gonna come in. These were super, super helpful for me. And then I didn't end up needing any nipple balm or nipple cream. I just didn't have any issues, but I brought it just in case. And there are a lot of women who need it. So make sure you bring nipple cream.
Better safe than sorry.
Yeah, exactly. I also brought my vitamins. I wanted to continue my vitamins when I was in the hospital, and I did every night. I never forgot, so make sure you bring some extra vitamins with you. Before I went into labor, my mother-in-law gave me a natural sponge, and she told me I could use it to suck on for liquids during labor. I didn't end up using it because I ended up using my water bottle the whole time and literally chugging water. So much water because I was so dehydrated. But I was very glad I had this as a little luck charm, I'd say, and I want to keep a tradition for my future children, and hopefully they keep up the tradition, because I just thought it was really sweet, and it's just something that I'm glad I had with me anyway. But make sure you have an easy to use water bottle at least, because you're gonna need water, and sometimes people just don't bring you water or anything in the hospital, so I made sure I brought that.
So as far as me and what I packed for the hospital, obviously just pack the necessities, just changes of clothes. Make sure to pack plenty of underwear, because like I said, you just don't know how long you're going to end up being there. So that was one of the kind of surprises for us, was like I said earlier, we just end up being there longer. But the other thing, as far as like the husbands or partners are concerned, you want to make sure that you can do whatever you can to help your wife or your partner when they're going through labor and everything. So one of the things that I made sure to bring was this massage gun that we have. So I knew that bringing this would be helpful, especially when Caitlin was going through her contractions and stuff. Good to have this to kind of help her through it and give her a massage in different places where she needed it.
Also, what I used during my labor was a yoga ball. He brought the yoga ball and the pump for it. It was just a hand pump. It was super helpful for me to do like hip circles and during really hard labor to bounce. It was helpful for me. I was so glad I had my yoga ball there. So he brought that for me as well as the massage gun.
Yeah, make sure when you buy one that comes already. Sometimes people buy them already blown up and stuff. Buy one that comes deflated in a box, deflated and with a little hand pump. And then that way it's so much easier to kind of pack it and bring it to the hospital with you.
Exactly. Make sure you bring plenty of snacks for yourself, for afterbirth, and for your husband during your labor and everything, because I'm going to insert the food that I was given here. He was not given any food because we were in a public hospital, they only gave me food, so he would have been starving if we didn't bring protein bars, snacks, water bottles.
Make sure to pack food that, like, almost like a packed lunch for the few, like, for how long you're going to be there. Because like Caitlin said, like, they only seen Caitlin as a patient. I was just her guest, so they didn't actually, I wasn't supplied any food.
Which wasn't a big deal because, again, this is the food that they're giving me, so I didn't touch the food
Caitlin
anyway.
Yeah, barely ate any of the food they gave her anyway. So yeah, so you want to make sure that you pack enough for you both to have enough to eat to get through the days. But make sure to pack, like, smart. Like, be smart when it comes to the food. Don't just pack a bunch of treats and chocolate.
Oh yeah, things that are nutritious and full of protein. The day after I gave birth, or actually the morning of I gave birth, I go to my room and I was expecting a nice breakfast and they gave me a coffee and a roll. I don't drink coffee and I wasn't gonna just need a roll.
Bread roll, yeah.
I needed actual nutrients. Bring food.
Yeah.
Bring half a duffel bag just of food,
full of, food
of snacks, because you're gonna need it. Last but not least, we packed quite a few things for our baby girl.
First and foremost was just nappy and wipes, or diapers and wipes. Obviously in the hospital, this is one of the essentials they provide, but they only give you a certain amount. You have to ask for more, so you're just better off having a few extras just in case.
Yeah, you might be waiting for quite a while, and we experienced that. We used quite a few of our own.
Yeah, there was a few times that we called and said we need some more stuff for the baby. They took maybe an hour to bring it to us because they were too busy, because, you know, maybe they're busy with someone else. So it was just nice to kind of have our own ones, not to rely on it, and especially in case of emergencies, like if there's a situation with the baby where you need to change them quickly, it's nice to have some backup. So
for sure,
these are good to pack as well. So this was the little swaddle set and hat that we packed for Sophie. This is what we chose to kind of take her announcement pictures in, but it's just important to have some warm clothes for the baby. They're very temperature sensitive when they're first born. Sophie was so temperature sensitive. She'd get too hot really easy and too cold really easy, so it's good to have enough clothing to keep them warm, warm blankets to keep them warm. Again, some of these things are stuff the hospital provide, but you just always want to make sure you have enough. We had an incident where Sophie had a bit of a blowout and, like, the blanket the hospital had given us got dirty, so we had to again wait for another blanket, and it was just nice to have our own. So as we mentioned, babies are very temperature sensitive when they're first born, so having little hats for their little head is so important to keep their little head warm. But another thing that we brought for Sophie was these little hand mittens. So when they're first born and they're moving their hands around and stuff, they don't really know what they're fully doing, and poor little Sophie, she kept, like, scratching her face and stuff. So these are so important to have, and to be able to put them on her hands and just keep her little skin safe and keep her little hands safe so that she wasn't scratching herself when she was fussing and moving around.
Yeah, and it's advice someone gave us in the hospital. We already had socks for our little Sophie, so they're super helpful for her feet, but also those mittens fall off a lot. So if you're debating whether or not to use the mittens or socks, it's actually socks. Better to use socks. So these are multi-purpose for their feet or for their hands. Make sure you bring them some socks.
Another thing that we brought for little Sophie was her little outfit for going home. So we'll flash up a little picture of her wearing this.
Yeah.
But when we were taking her out of the hospital, we wanted to make sure that we had a little cute outfit to present her in. Sometimes people don't think about that, and then it's something they're like, oh, I wish we did that, you know, especially for photos or meeting loved ones. So for us, that was important for us, was to pack her a little outfit when we were leaving the hospital.
Exactly. So make sure, obviously, you bring a car seat. For us, we just had a normal car seat. We recently purchased a Duna. He's going to be so sick of me mentioning this Duna.
I've heard the word Duna a million times.
But I'm going to insert what a Duna is here, a little bit of how it works. But it's basically a stroller and a car seat in one. Anyway, I wish I just had a Duna from the get-go and we never purchased.
So handy.
Yeah, I wish we never purchased a car seat, because we use the Duna everywhere for a quick grocery shop, anything we're doing. And it's so much better because then you don't have to take the baby who's asleep out of the car seat and then you put them in their stroller. Get yourself a Duna. I wish I had one from the beginning, but we waited till she was 2 months old.
And then last but not least, we have this. This is like a car seat cover. So yeah, so this is really handy because it's important to protect their little eyes and their skin from direct sunlight and things like that. So if you're leaving the hospital in the middle of the day, you know, you want to have some kind of a cover. So this one's really nice. It's really flexible material, really cool. But then this one's really cool because it also works as a two-in-one. So Caitlin's able to use this for breastfeeding. And then it's also a cover up for the car seat as well.
Exactly. So anyway, that's just a few of our must-haves for our hospital stay. If we missed anything, please comment below, because I'm curious as to what you had to have in the hospital. But that's just things that we packed and they were super useful. So anyway, thank you for watching and bearing with us during this video, because we had a lot of things we packed.
Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. We hope that this video is helpful, especially for anyone who's preparing for their own hospital trip in the near future. And make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Share it with anyone who might need it.
And as always, thanks for watching.
Bye.